High Point breaks a scoreless tie here against Pope John off the corner penalty. Watch Carly Satter find Rachel Orr, who scores, and High Point takes a 1-0 lead 9 minutes into the first half. The Wildcats look to make it 2-0 here on this flurry in front of the Pope John cage, but it's Lions keeper Sam Scalabrini with a couple of big saves to keep it 1-0. All right, High Point gets another corner, and it's Satter again with a nice feed to Alexis Ambrosino, who rifles in the rocket to make it 2-0 High Point midway through the first half. High Point ends the half on a good note. Watch the nice clear here by Maddie Smith, who connects with Carly Satter, who does the rest by herself with a pretty goal, and High Point has a 3-0 lead over Pope John at the half. All right, second half action we go, and yet off another High Point corner, it's Brittany DeLima with the blast, but Sam Scalabrini is there for the save for the Lions. But DeLima would not be denied here off the scrum in front of the cage. She taps in the loose ball, and the Wildcats take a 4-0 lead over the Lions here at Pope John High School. The Wildcats are on the run again as Maddie Smith beats Alexis Ambrosino, who's denied by Scalabrini, but on the rebound, she knocks it home, and High Point has a 5-0 lead. The Wildcats capped the big American Division win here, watching Alexis Ambrosino reach out, and she scores her third goal of the game as High Point blanks Pope John 6-0.
We definitely came in not too level-headed because we knew that coming into this that we couldn't get too cocky or else we played down to their level. We came back from a game Saturday at Pingree, and that was a really well team, probably one of the best teams we'll play other than in HWS tournament or in states. And we came in off a tie with that, so we tried not to stay too cocky and level-headed. And when we first came in, warm-ups were really slow, and we were all chatty, and Coach Kerr pulled us all together, and she's like, you know, that's not acceptable. Go do another warm-up lap and really do stretches and focus. So we did, and I think we did start off really slow. But at halftime, we had a long talk about we have to start cutting to the ball and pick up the intensity. And after that talk, I really think that our passes started looking a lot better. We connected really well, and the flow of the game just got a lot better in how we usually play.
We came in here making sure that we were on fire and at least trying to come out with four goals. So
really pleased with how the girls responded after playing Pingree on Saturday. We would love to have a turf field, so it's always great to be on a turf field and take a look at a lot of our skills on this field. I'm really proud of how all of them played. A lot of the girls that are learning this game for the first time at the varsity level got into the game and played very well as a team.
High Point's attack has been very explosive this year. 6 goals today, 3 by Alexis Ambrosino.
She really is a playmaker and has a real good nose for the cage. The other thing that's so impressive about her is because she's small and scrappy, she really gets down in there with her stick and makes a lot of things happen around that goalie's pads.
High Point goalie Autumn Smith didn't even have to see a shot on goal, and that's because of the field defense spearheaded by Michaela O'Hearn.
We knew we were ready for Pingree. We practiced really hard. We're really proud of the offense. As much as we like to get action back there, it's nice that we don't because that means that we're winning. So we just got to make sure that we keep the ball out and play hard.
We've been priding ourselves also in our tandem defense and working hard at who's calling for ball and who's going to recover back. And one of the things I'm really noticing is the communication is getting much better. The girls who have been playing for a few years with me understand the game, and they're being tremendous leaders out there on the field.
The Hunter and Warren Sussex tournament seedings will come out this week. High Point made the final last year, lost a heartbreaker to Voorhees. The Wildcats know how to get there, and they're hoping to get back and this year win it.
Coming in second the past few years is really frustrating, and I think we really have a great chance to make it all the way and win this time if we really put our hearts into it, work together as a team, and go all the way.
We just want to get further than we did last year. We want to win it. We want to take it home. So
it'll be great to be back in there again. I know that a lot of those Hunter and Warren and Sussex County teams are all solid. So when we get those seedings, we cannot take for granted that if we get seeded 1 or 2 or 3, that it really means a lot. We need to make sure that we're playing good quality High Point hockey.
5-0-1 sounds pretty good to Coach Bev Kerr and the Wildcats.
We've been working really hard in practice ever since preseason. We've been pushing ourselves just to make sure that we come out in the season hard like this and making sure we have a good, clean record.
Right where I want to be right now, right where I expected us to be. And I think it generates a lot of confidence for us and also continues to help us build tomorrow at practice on the next parts of the game that we need to gain more stability in.